So next up, we have Browserling. This is James and Peter, and they have a. Before they get started, I just want to call out. They have a sort of an amazing startup dream slash Silicon Valley story. James is actually from Alaska, and Peter from Latvia, and they met on a IRC chat room. Is that right?
Right.
And started coding together, working on some things, pivoted through some different ideas, but managed to create Browserling, and I think drove in a somewhat derelict car down from Alaska to Silicon Valley to kind of see out that dream.
By the time I got to Santa Rosa, it was smoking profusely. I had to pull off the highway, and of course the transmission had gone out.
It's too warm for an Alaskan car. So, but I'll let you guys take it from here. So.
Yes, so I'm Peter from Browserling, and this is James.
I'm James.
And so Browserling is an interactive cross-browser testing site. So we run browsers in your browser. So I'll just start with going to some URL. Let's say my blog, catonmat.net. Maybe someone has in this room has seen it because it's a really popular blog. And then you can select the browsers that you want to view the website in. Let's say Opera, and you click Go button. And it should open. In Opera, yeah, here it goes. Oh yeah, we have these annoying flash.
Yeah, so that's a real browser running there. It's
right.
Not just...
So we run the browser on Amazon EC2, and then we stream the desktop to the browser, and you can interact with the browser like click links and and scroll down, and even type stuff like let's say I want to add that comment. There is testing. So it's all interactive. And you can easily switch between the browsers. Let's say you want to feel how your site looks in. So it will be Chrome in Chrome. So the service is useful for web developers and designers who want to make sure that their website looks correctly in all the browsers. That's a common issue. And the way they solve it right now is either have a separate computer with all the browsers installed, or they have a virtual machine. But with Browserling, you don't really need that. You can just you switch between the browsers easily. And and we have all kinds of
A
versions.
We've got a good assortment of Internet Explorer versions. I think that's the biggest pain point that developers seem to run up against.
Yeah, and at the moment we're adding the debuggers, so we'll have the debuggers in each of the browsers, so you can actually, if something is wrong in one of the browsers when you're testing, you can just pull up the browser and see what's wrong. And then we also have this cool feature here, resolution changing. So let's say you want to see how your website looks on a smaller screen, let's say really small, like a mobile screen, so you just click there, and it takes a few seconds to change the resolution. Yeah, here. And you can put the one-to-one mode or the fit mode. And we can even do arbitrary resolutions, let's say 500 by 500. And it actually changes the resolution on the virtual machine on Amazon. So yeah, we figured that part out.
Another neat thing about our service is that's just HTML5 canvas. So
yeah,
no plugins whatsoever. It's just pure JavaScript.
And so at the moment, we are working on tunnels. You'll be able to have your local, you'll be able to pull up your local development copy in Browserling.
Yeah, so oftentimes when you're developing a website and you want to make sure that it still works in, say, IE7, it's pretty much too late by the time you've already deployed to a publicly accessible internet website to be caring about, you know, cross-browser compatibility. So with tunnels, you'll be able to sort of interactively spot check your website in all of these different browsers just from your web browser, and you won't have to deploy anywhere. It'll be really simple.
Right, and you can also leave comments. So if you try the service out and something doesn't work, please leave a comment so we can fix it and see what was going on. That about covers Browserling.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
questions.
Please.
Do you see this supporting the browsers, or maybe it already does support the browsers within mobile devices and touchpads?
We have thought about that. We'll support them in the future. Not at the moment, but we'll have them in the future.
Yeah, so.
We just got funded, so we have money to spend investigating.
Yeah.
So I ran an extensive project that involved this very problem. How far back, two questions, how far back do you go in IE? And can you test multiple different versions of operating systems underneath the browser on both Windows and Mac side?
Okay, so the question was, how far back do we go down the Windows version hole? And so right now we're actually just using IE Tester for different Internet Explorer versions. We are working on getting actual real Windows instances, like Windows 2000 or earlier, maybe. I don't know. I'm not sure.
So at the moment we have like IE 5, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9.
Yeah, we do plan to fill that out a bit more and make it better in the future.
But,
yes.
But how does the grid on operating systems go right now?
So at the moment, we have just Windows 2008. That's what Amazon has.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. So you're totally dependent upon what...
At the moment, yes, but we have plans to get our own servers and then...
Well,
have
yeah,
all kinds
also
of
Amazon
Windows.
Lets you upload VMDK images, so we'll be rolling that out too. It's just
in a
matter of priorities, so...
We should talk.
Okay.
Yeah, back there?
How about automating the testing in all these different versions?
Automation. Right, so we're trying to approach this, I think, initially from a sort of low barrier to entry sort of approach to automation. So we'll be slowly rolling out different types of automations. Nothing as heavyweight as like Selenium right away, but we'll see how that goes. I think initially we'll just have playlists to sort of quickly spot check, and we want to do like some script injection and maybe bake some crawling into that. For now, we've got some stuff in the pipeline to better automate that, but we're still experimenting. So,
yeah, so one of the ideas that we'll have, so you'll probably have is, so you'll set your reference browser, let's say Chrome. You'll say the page has to look like this, but there are some regions that are changing. So you would tell that those regions are changing, and then we would periodically check if this site looks okay in all the other browsers and do some image matching. That's one of the
How about
ideas.
Back there.
About testing.
First of all, do you have full screen mode as well? And the second question, what about the pricing
of the monetization and full screen. So we have something sort of like full screen. It's not quite full screen yet. It's 1-to-1 mode, so it's pixel to pixel. We're using Canvas, so it's really cool. We can stretch things arbitrarily. You can put it in 1-to-1.
I'll show that in a minute. So But about the pricing, so we have this freemium service, so you can use it for 3 minutes. If you just go to browserling.com, you can use it for 3 minutes at a time for free. But then if you want unlimited service, you need to do some more debugging and using the service more. Then you can pay us $20 a month, and you get an unlimited service for a month.
Also, tunnels will be coming out soon, mm-hmm. and that will be available to our paid users. So.
Right, and the full screen mode, go back here. So we have this.
Yeah, 1-to-1 mode. I don't know if that's exactly
what
you're
saying. It's
not
exactly
but
full screen, but it would say
We might mess with
one.
That a bit later, but yeah.
So,
okay.
Yes?
I have a quick question. So we have, for our testing, we have a Safari running on an Apple. So when the application is done, we just run it on that one. With this one, we have to put the URL, right? If you go to your website, your hosting, how confident can I be that this is the exact same thing as a browser running on an Apple? Or underneath, under the hood, what is that? Is that another browser, Safari browser that is running? How does it work out?
So we have the actual browsers running. At the moment, they are running on the Windows.
So it's a Safari, for example,
it's Safari
running. I'm sorry, go ahead.
It's Safari running on Windows, so.
Okay, so it's not Safari running on Apple.
No.
Okay.
But we have some plans on that as well. So we investigated how we could do the Mac hosting. There are possibilities to do Mac hosting, and then we can run native Safari on Mac, and then you can use the service with the Safari running on a Mac.
Should do one more?
Okay. Anyone?
Last question.
No more questions.
Cool.
Okay.
Here we go.
So, how do you store? Do you keep all those cookie and security?
Okay. Yeah. So for each one of the browsers, I went through and investigated where they store the cookies, history, like local storage, and all this stuff like bookmarks. And then after each session, everything gets cleared. So after I have finished using the site and you come, you get a fresh browser with no settings at all.
Okay.
Great. Thanks, guys.
Okay. Thank you.
For the non-technical folks, this Browserling really addresses a big pain point in designing websites, which is just that not all browsers are created equal. You could write a page, open it in IE or something like that, and it looks like somebody else's page entirely. So it's a great pain point to solve.